Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the pleasure of telling you 10 tips for beginners that'll make you a better guitar player. Now, a couple of years ago, we shot something similar to this. It was the things that I wish I was told when I was starting out, when I was a beginner, and I'll link that video in the description box down below. This is kind of just expanding on that because people learn more things and things change over time. And with that as well, if you want to comment anything down below to expand on anything that I've talked about in this video, feel free to, because I like learning about this stuff just as much as you guys. Some of it may be obvious to some people, some of it may be not so obvious. It's not going to be so in depth where it's like, tap here to do this. None of that kind of stuff. It's going to be just stuff to help you on the stepping stones of your guitar playing career. So hopefully in a few years time, I can watch you play Wembley Stadium and be like, yeah, that's my advice right there. But yeah, anyways, let's get into it with the first tip. Now, the first one is pretty obvious, but I think it's forgotten about quite a lot. After working in a guitar shop for many years, people will get too regimented in their beginner guitar playing journey. The first tip is to just play songs that you like. Obviously, when you sit down and Google how to learn guitar, it's like, practice these scales and chords, and you sit there going... Oh no, I've ruined it! You kind of got to do that alongside it, but you've just got to remember that... I'm guessing the reason you've started playing guitar is because you want to be like an idol, whether you watch Brian May from Queen, or Sinister Gates from Avenged Sevenfold, or John Mayer, or whatever. You want to be as cool as those guys, so... Learn fun songs that you enjoy. Don't get caught up in too much theory and too much regimented scale practice and stuff. It's not a bad thing playing along to these songs. Kind of ties into tip two as well, and the sooner you learn to play along to a metronome or play in time, the better. So play along to a metronome is one. You can get metronomes for your phones these days. You haven't just got to use one of those old school little rock back and forth ones. I use Metro Timer. It's all it is, different variants, and you can practice along to the, like on the beat. That kind of thing, but I want to expand on that more than just playing along with the metronome. So the same as tip one, playing along with songs you enjoy will get your timing better. I know a few people that have started out and just play songs they enjoy, like I keep saying, but they don't play along with the track. So you've got to be in time with the drums and get... Playing along in time is crucial, and whether you're with the metronome or playing along with an actual track, that's kind of key. And the third thing is when you do want to practice scales and you don't want to play along with songs and you do just want to regimentally go... Either do that with a metronome or for a bit more enjoyment as a guitar player, on YouTube there's loads of backing tracks. So find out what scale you're playing, like A major, and just YouTube A major backing track and just jam along. That kind of thing. So metronome, play along with the songs actually themselves, so you're in time with it, and jam along to backing tracks when you do want to practice your scales and stuff. Next tip. Tip number three is to use a tone for the occasion. Now, I'm guilty of this as well. I love distortion. It's loads of fun. You do stuff like that and it sounds awesome. However, when you start jamming, whether it be along with a rock backing track or like a bluesy backing track, don't just ramp the gain up on your amplifier. Use a tone for the occasion. So when you start a jam with your friends and stuff, or you're at school and you start a jam, say you might like Metallica and stuff, and your mate's a big Stevie Ray Vaughan fan, you can't rock up and go... But in turn, they also can't rock up and be like... So when it comes to jamming, try and find a tone which suits the occasion. You might find a middle ground between you. You might want to go out your comfort zone a little bit, because that's a lot of fun as a guitar player as well. So if you're not into like jazzy bluesy stuff, maybe have a little dip your toe into a bit of jazzy blues, because it'll expand your knowledge of the guitar. And same with, don't be nasty to your bluesy mate by going, learn Metallica! But I don't know, going vice versa is good, but crucially, have a tone that fits the occasion in which you're playing. Whether you're recording for someone, jamming along with the backing track, or jamming with an actual physical friend. Next up, sticking with tone, when you practice and you don't want to play along with it, or you just want to play along with the metronome, you're not using a tone for a certain occasion, try not to practice with too much distortion, because it's less forgiving. When you play with gain and stuff, you can make a couple of mistakes and it kind of just all blends into the saturation, like... still sounded kind of cool, but if you do that on a clean sound... It sounds like trash and it's much less forgiving when you play with a clean sound. Oh, f*** that up as well. Haha! So if I had some distortion on there, it would kind of just like kind of fiddle in, you can get away with it. Maybe do a pick scrape and move on to the next chord, but clean. Everything is a lot clearer and more direct, so you can hear your mistakes more, which is great for practicing because you can work your way out of those mistakes when you're playing scales and stuff. If certain notes, say if you're working on something I'm gonna get to in a second, and you might not press down as hard with your little pinky, so when it's clean, you can tell that a bit more and you can work on it to make it even as the rest of your digits. Next up, not surprisingly, work on that pinky strength. Pinky strength is crucial. If you don't want to use your pinky, that's totally fine. There's loads of amazing guitar players out there which don't really use the pinky that often. However, I found it was way weaker than the rest of my fingers when I first started to like really get into guitar playing, like play it more of a, I don't know, wanted to do it as a career. My pinky was always lacking when it came to scales and chords and stuff, especially when you start to learn Van Halen and stuff like that. Like, I was like, I can't stretch on my third finger, I have to work on my fourth finger. And it took ages to get up to strength. So if you're starting out, focusing on that little finger is crucial. I've seen a few people online, like Phil X. He does stuff where, say if you're learning your scales, only use your first and your little finger to get the... So only use your little finger to get, like, just be creative with it and get the strength into your little finger as easy as you do when you're first learning to play guitar with your first, second, and third, because you kind of already only use those guys. Get your pinky involved. That was awful. But you know what I mean. So yeah, work on your pinky off the bat. It's important if you want to do Eddie Van Halen stuff in the future, like I assume you do, because Eddie is God. Next up, something I should purvey a bit more in this video, but I'm quite giddy today, so I'm talking quite fast, I'm playing quite fast. And that is slow and steady wins the race. You have to practice slow, you can't just jump into, like I was showing you there, these scales of my pinky. Trying to go far too fast, because you don't really do it that often. So when it comes to practicing, start low with that metronome like I was talking about earlier, or a slow backing track, and slowly build up speed. I know it's not as fun. I've been guilty of this many times in my past when I want to learn something. I'm just like, yeah, let's go, ready! And you mess up loads of notes and stuff, and you're like, you have to play it slowly to understand where you are on the fretboard and get better, so that you can then show off and play fast once you've learned it. So yeah, slow and steady wins the race. You have to practice slow to then be as good as our guitar playing heroes, because you've got to remember, even if you're in a guitar store and there's someone there trying to show off, which the staff like myself don't really care about, or you're watching your heroes play guitar on stage. There was a time, many moons ago, when they were sat, Nuno Bettencourt, Steve Vai, Joe Satriani, Angus Young, all sat in their room practicing slowly. If you think that you suck because you're a certain level because you're practicing stuff slowly, every guitar player in the world, myself included, have been there and done it. Now this one kind of ties in for the next tip, and that is to just not compare yourself to other guitar players. That and give up in general. A lot of times I've seen working here in a PMT store when people buy their lovely first guitar, I always say, don't give up. You're not going to be like Eddie Van Halen as soon as you pick it up. It takes a bit of time. Your fingers are going to hurt. Your hand's going to hurt. It's going to get frustrating. But don't give up, because there will be a point where it just kind of clicks in your head and you're like, oh, I get it. I get it. This is fantastic. So there is a point where it clicks. But again, don't compare yourself to others, because people learn at different speeds. Like, I've been trying to learn a sweep pick for years. I just never do it. I can't do it. A lot of my mates can, who've been playing guitar for a lot less time than me. But can I help you? One day I might be able to. But I got over the fact that I couldn't do it by comparing myself to others. So if you're having guitar lessons with someone the same age or even younger, if they're better than you and you're not as good as them, it doesn't really matter. As long as everyone's on the same path and having fun playing guitar, that is very important. Now here's an actual tip. Try different guitar picks. When you're starting out, try and get an assortment of guitar picks. You can buy little Dunlop or Fender picks, which come in different sizes, shapes, thicknesses, materials. I'll show you a couple of my favorites. My always go-to picks are these Jazz 3 XLs, the 1.14 ones. I've only used these this past year, Before that, I used little Jazz 3s, these tiny little picks, which are great for articulation and stuff, but I also felt like, personally, I mean, loads of people use these, like Joe Bonamassa and stuff, I preferred a thicker pick for when it comes to strumming and stuff. They all sound pretty much the same. The smaller picking kind of... But again, Paul Gilbert has a massive pick and he does that just fine. It's all finding the right one for you. If you're an acoustic player, more strummy, a lot of the times off the bat, the thinner picks will be better for you because you kind of get the... It's a bit more of a rake. But you do get a bit of that pick noise. But I personally, I feel like I can't find the notes that I want to pick between my fingers because the pick's flapping too much off the string it's just previously been on. And it's quite fun though. Actually, what size is this? 46, this is the same kind of pick Paul Gilbert uses, and he is one of the fastest guitar players on the planet, so it's all personal preference. A lot of players will use either the yellow or the green Dunlop picks, and kind of a good happy medium. This is a 0.88, so it's 0.88 of a millimeter. So yeah, to try a few different picks out to find the one that's right for you. Now the penultimate tip is the one that I always say whenever I get asked a tip for guitar players, and that is to practice standing up. I've said it in previous videos and I will continue saying it till the day that I die. Practice standing up, because it's a totally different ballgame to practicing sitting down. When you play that, sitting down, what can I sit on? I'm gonna get a chair. So when you sat down, the guitar is a lot closer to you. And if you notice that I always play guitar standing up, whether I'm practicing or like jamming or like whatever, I'm always playing guitar standing up, especially in videos. Guitar's about having fun, it's a lot more active when you're standing up. But when you sat down practicing, it's a bit easier because the guitar's a bit closer to you. It's comfy and it's not so bad on your legs. However, if you're like me and you grew up enjoying Slash, Slash has guitar very low. And when you... This is where it was when I was sitting down. And that is quite easy. Actually, it's a lot easier than having it low. However, I wanted my guitar low because I wanted to stand in front of the mirror and pretend I was Slash. So when the guitar gets lower, your hand curves in a different way. Both hands react differently when the guitar is lower. So the sooner you get to this stage and feel, the better, because you don't want to like practice and be great sitting down, go to play a jam with your first band and then play standing up and be like, oh crap, the guitar's too low, but I want to look cool and have it low. Obviously high guitars are fine, Tom Morello and Eddie Van Halen are high guitars, but I like low guitars. So if you're all like this and you're like, oh man, it's not what I thought it would be, practice with it low and get your hand used to playing at this kind of angle. And you can use the chair to do stuff like that. I might just have a chair here now. I nearly fell. I might just have a chair here now for in the future. Ah, I don't know what I'm doing today.
I mean, that was good
enough, wasn't it? So yeah, maybe the chair was a bad idea because the camera just got knackered. That brings me on to the last tip, and that is to just have fun. Guitar playing is about having fun. Whether you want to practice loads or you don't want to practice at all, if you just want to stand in front of your mirror with a guitar and just play an A chord, and have the most fun in the world. You totally can. Don't be pressurized by anyone on YouTube, any of your friends, or anything to tell you otherwise. If you're not having fun, then it's pointless playing the guitar, and that's why you shouldn't get too bogged down in all this scale practice and stuff. You know, obviously you need to improve, you need to get the dexterity in your fingers and stuff and learn how to actually play the instrument, but don't get bogged down in it because it might not be fun anymore, and it might become something like a chore or a job. And like when you're at school and stuff, sometimes when you learn stuff periodically and intensely, you can kind of suck the fun out of it, and you don't want to do that with guitar because it is a lot of fun. It's the most fun in the world. So that's my last tip. Simply have fun, and why you should have fun, because if you don't, I'm gonna come to your door and tell you to have fun, and you will. I'm losing my mind today, this is far too fun. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen, all my lovely tips for beginners out there, and a mild threat at the end, because why the devil not? If you want to add anything, please comment down below and expand on anything that I've talked about, or just add other things. There's other videos here at PMTVUK. I'll link everything in the description box down below. And yeah, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on anything I've spoken about today, this lovely Kramer Viper, the Boss Katana Artist Mark II, I've just kicked the light as well. This is absolute carnage now. Get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk. I'll link these in the description box down below as well. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of all these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and it's been a pleasure as always. I'll see you next time.